चैप्टर 4 द आर्ट ऑफ ट्रेडिंग। ट्रेडिंग इज अबाउट मनी एंड मनी अराउजेस इमोशंस। दैट मीन्स अ पर्सन हैज़ सम काइंड ऑफ फीलिंग और सम काइंड ऑफ इमोशन व्हेन इट कम्स टू मनी। सो लूजिंग मनी क्रिएट्स फियर एंड गेनिंग मनी क्रिएट्स ग्रीड ऑल्सो। सो मनी कैन अराउज emotions of a person, so it is related to psychology also. Then there is something beyond technical skills, that is more an art, an intuitive feel for what market is thinking. So we apply all indicators, we apply all technical skills, but beyond that there is a intuitive feel. That means beyond that also there is a feeling about there are some magic numbers or there are some support resistance levels. So these comes under an intuitive feel for what market is thinking. That is news also. So beyond that mathematical calculations also, there is something beyond that skills also. So we should be consider it about that also while studying technical analysis. So let us discuss about noise. Where does noise comes from? So there may be some sources of noise. Where it is coming from? Noise arises from an external shock which can be big or small. That means an external event or external news or external big or small fluctuations. Noise can arise from that. Then Perry Kaufman pictures noise as raindrops falling on a pond causing what looks like random ripples. So it is a very, here it is, Perry Kaufman is giving a very beautiful explanation for noise as raindrops. So if you are sitting next to a pond or on a calm evening or a calm day and you are just observing it and suddenly rain starts, then noise is like raindrops which are falling on surface of that pond. So on that surface of pond, raindrops are falling on it and thus surface of that pond is fluctuating and it creates some ripples. It is creating some ripples around that fluctuation, around that, on that surface, it is creating some ripples. So that is noise. Then classification of indicators. First is judgment based indicators. It includes recognition methods such as bar, line and pattern analysis. They can be back tested. So judgment based indicators include recognition methods such as bar chart, then line chart, then pattern analysis, etc. So this comes under judgment based indicators. Then they can be back tested. They can also be, judgment based indicator can also be back tested. Then second is math based indicators. They include moving average. Math based indicators include things like, first is moving average, then regression lines. So these are a group of indicators which involve mathematical calculations. That means finding simple moving average, that is averaging the price, then exponential moving average, that is finding average over a certain period of time by applying some extra formulas. So that comes under math based indicators. Then remember the use of math does not confer a crown of authenticity. That means if people are very judgmental or they trust mathematics a lot. That means they think like if you are applying some mathematical formulas, then the answer must be authentic or it should be 100% correct or 100% genuine. People think like that. So here we should remember that use of mathematical indicators does not confirm a crown of authenticity. That means the results are not authentic even if we use mathematical based indicators. Then I am putting some suggestions next to each condition. So these are some conditions and these are on left hand side, and there are some suggestions on right hand side. First condition, a trend is beginning. That means a trend is starting. Then suggestion is moving average crossover occurs. Moving average, so we will discuss about crossover afterwards. Just remember that moving average crossover can occur if trend is beginning, or pattern breakout. That means a pattern is broken. So we will discuss about pattern also. Then second is a trend is strong or weak. That means how strong is trend or how weak is trend. So that is a condition, and for that suggestion is slope of linear regression. So linear regression line gives slope of that. Then a trend is retracing or likely resume. So trend is retracing or likely to resume. That means trend is going upwards or trend is resuming. That is suggested by relative strength index. Then trend is ending and may reverse. That is trend is now ending. So if it was uptrend, it will go sideways or downtrend. If it was downtrend, then it will go sideways or upwards. So that means trend is ending and may reverse. So this is a condition, and for that suggestion is momentum moving average crossover or pattern breakout. That means moving average of momentum crossover occurs or pattern is breaking out. Choosing trading style. Identifying trendedness is always your first task. Then examining how indicators work. Indicators cannot easily categorized as belonging to trend or trend trading or swing trading. Indicators cannot be categorized as a trending. It can only be used in trending markets or non-trending markets or neutral markets, or so we cannot describe them in that category. Then you cannot use a long-term moving average for like 50 days. So you cannot use a long-term moving average, that is like 50 days, for swing trading on a chart. So it is different. Then finding relevant time frames. That means finding appropriate time frame, that is 1 hour, then 15 minutes, then half an hour. Finding time frames such that it is also important. So most indicators measure price and volume changes relative to previous price and volume over a specific look back period, such as 12 days or 21 days. That means most indicators like moving average, then relative strength index, they measures price and volume changes in accordance with previous price and volume over specific period. Then reading indicator signals. Indicators generate signals in three ways as described in following sections. First is crossover. The term crossover refers to one line crossing another line. So crossover means crossing of one line on another line. So that is crossover. So it occurs in moving averages. Price crossing a fixed historic benchmark. So it can be occur under certain conditions. So price crossing a fixed historic breaker benchmark. This is first condition. Then indicator crossing price on or price crossing indicator. That means indicator is crossing price. That is it is above price or indicator is below price. Then or price is above indicator. So it is crossing that indicator. So it is second indication. Then one line of two line indicator is crossing another. So one line of indicator, that is say 50 day moving average, so it is crossing 100 day moving average. It is like that. Then range limit. Oscillators describe where today's price stands. So range limit is trading range. So the range in which on which price is moving, so that is a range limit. Range limit. Oscillators describe where today's price stands relative to its recent trading range. So related to its recent trading range, where the price is standing, so that is range limit. Then convergence and divergence. Convergence refers to two indicator lines coming closer to another. That means they both are confirming each other's opinions, so that is convergence. Then divergence. Divergence refers to two indicator lines moving apart, such as spread between two moving averages widen. That means two moving averages are spreading apart from each other, so that is divergence. And if they are coming closer, then it is convergence. So convergence is basically that means it is a confirmation from both indicators, so that is convergence. And divergence is the difference in prediction of both indicators. It is divergence. Then evaluating the risks and backtest. Critics of backtesting points out, so there are some evaluating the risk of backtest. Critics of backtesting point out, you can go mad backtesting until you are blue in face and you will never find out the optimum parameter that stays over time. That means there are some people who are against backtesting. So they point out that you can go mad backtesting. That means it has no meaning. So there is no optimum parameter that stays over time. So some people think like that, but some people do backtesting and they generate their trading systems also. So there is a difference between both traders.